Hey guys, we're here with Mary Dalton, and she's the Ombudsman with Missoula Aging Services, and she's here to talk about Residents' Rights Month at Missoula Aging Services, and of course, many of the in-home living facilities out of Missoula. So October is Residents' Rights Month. So Mary, let's talk a little bit about this.
Well, thanks for having us. Missoula Aging Services appreciates your partnership, and we always like to come and visit with you and have conversations about our different programs. And so the Ombudsman program is one of many programs offered through Missoula Aging Services. And as you know, our mission is to promote the independence, dignity, and health of older adults and those who care for them.
Awesome. And so this is an event that happens every year, and this year's theme is
Speak up. Know your rights and how to use them.
Yeah.
So that's right. Every October is Resident Rights Month, and it's just an opportunity to celebrate and honor those living in long-term care. And the theme for 2018 focuses on resident rights. So we want to really empower people to understand what their rights are and how to use those rights and feel confident in speaking up and exercising their rights.
Cool. And we were talking a little about this before the show. We were talking about rights and just talking about some of the living care facilities. And a lot of times, Missoula Aging Services is really good about helping people who are 55 and older who definitely have like issues with mobility and a lot of times need in-care housing and stuff like that.
Right.
And I think this is a very important event, and even if it's just to highlight some things, it's always a good idea just to kind of talk about this. It's just a nice way to open a conversation, something that a lot of times when people retire, it's always kind of like, it's like, oh, they're kind of, I don't know, it's so weird when you really think about it. It's like when a person retires, they're not part of the workforce, and so much of the United States in general is your work, is working because you work so much.
Right, and I think that's, really an important part of Resident Rights Month and the Ombudsman Program and being an advocate for the residents who do live in long-term care. Really honoring the contributions that people have made throughout the course of their workforce and understanding that they still have a lot of things that they can contribute to the community. And, having them be involved in Resident Rights Month and helping people to understand some of what resident rights are. And, a lot of it is about dignity and respect. And quality of life and quality of care are sort of the cornerstones of resident rights. And so we really want people in general to understand and to help people who live in long-term care to understand what their rights are and how to exercise those. And so, I meet with people on a regular basis that live in long-term care, and I let them know about the Ombudsman Program and that I can help advocate on their behalf and really try to empower them to utilize and understand what those rights are. And resident rights are much like civil rights and constitutional rights. Those rights don't go away just because you live in long-term care. And in fact, they have even more rights. And, you think about this is their home. And so if you're entering someone's home, you're thinking about the dignity and respect of that person. And, you would knock on the door, you would wait to ask to be seated, and just being really respectful of their space and cultivating that sort of culture. And resident rights are like an ongoing thing. It's not something that you do on a checklist and then you move on to the rest of your day. It's sort of throughout the day and throughout the weeks, and just building that culture and that supportive environment of promoting and honoring resident rights in the facilities.
Yep, and speak up is very important as well, but I think alluding to where people can speak up too. Who do they go to?
So one of the great things about that, and I think ways that people in the community can get involved, is to visit people in long-term care. One of the primary rights of residents in long-term care is to be able to contact their ombudsman, so they can always contact Missoula Aging Services at 728-7682 or visit our website. And I do confidential consultations with people. I meet one-on-one with people. I give out lists of resident rights so people can contact our organization to get the information on resident rights. But also visiting with people in long-term care and letting, just building that relationship helps to empower people. It's amazing what just that human interaction and that human connection can do for a person who lives in long-term care to sort of get rid of some of that isolation and some of those feelings of just like being alone.
Yeah.
You know, just having that human connection really, it's very restorative for the person and helps to empower them, which is the ultimate goal to having quality of life and quality of care.
Nice.
Is to empower people to speak up and exercise those rights. And
is there anything else you want to mention about this?
I think basically just if you have an opportunity to visit family or friends in long-term care, October would be a great time to do that, and just call Missoula Aging Services. I'd love to visit with people about resident rights and how they can get involved, and if they have concerns or problems, if they have someone living in a facility, I'm always available to help with those types of questions.
Awesome. Well, thanks, Mary. This was Mary Dalton. She's from Missoula Aging Services. If you are interested in finding out more about Missoula Aging Services, you can go to MissoulaAgingServices.org, or you can call them at
728-7682.
Yep. Well, thanks, Mary. I really appreciate you coming on.
Yeah, thank you.